Today feels like it's been so long.
It only feels that way because we haven't caught much today.
No, it's not just that. Every day feels, I don't know, we just do the same thing over and over and over again. Catching fish and getting old.
I think you're just tired. Perhaps we should rest here a little while longer.
No, come on. Let's test it back out.
Alright, give me that side.
I don't think we're going to catch anything.
I don't know. There's still time. I'm sure we'll pull in some fish.
Do you need help with your net?
Thanks, but we caught very little today, and same with yesterday. And it's been like that for a while, and I don't think we're going to catch anything.
Don't mind Peter. He's just tired of trying to catch fish every day.
Then drop your net. Come follow me, and I'll make you fishers of men.
Okay.
So, we're just going to leave this here?
All right. We've got to get these nets fixed so we can get back out on the water. The sooner we get it done, the sooner we can go fishing.
You're just in a hurry to get the work done so that we can head home and eat.
Come on, son. Now let's get this done.
Come, there's work to be done. Hello.
You're the one. The one people's been talking about. Jesus.
Follow me. Blessed are the poor in spirit, for theirs is the kingdom of God. Blessed are those who mourn, for they will be comforted. Blessed are the meek, for they will inherit the earth. Blessed are those who hunger and thirst for righteousness, for they will be filled. Blessed are the persecuted, for theirs is the kingdom of God. Blessed are you when people insult you and falsely say all kinds of evil against you because of me. Rejoice and be glad, for great is your reward in heaven. For in the same way they persecuted the prophets who were before me. You are the salt of the earth. But if the salt loses its saltiness, how can it be made salty again? It's good for nothing, except to be trampled by men. You are the light of the world. A city on a hill cannot be hidden. Neither do people light a lamp and put it under a bowl. Instead, they put it on its stand, and it gives light to everyone in the house. In the same way, let your light shine before men so they may see your good deeds and praise your Father in heaven. Do not think I have come to abolish the law and the prophets. I have not come to abolish them, but to fulfill them. Therefore, anyone who sets aside even the least of these commands will be called least in heaven. But those who practice and teach these commands will be called great in the kingdom of heaven. For I tell you the truth, unless your righteousness surpasses that of the Pharisees and teachers of the law, you will not enter heaven.
Look at him! Why is he spending all his time with such scum?
No true teacher of the law would associate with such sinners.
Thank you for stopping by, Lord, but I'm not worth your time. I've made so many mistakes.
You spend your time in a place like this with people like them and claim to be a man of God?
Follow me.
But Lord, I'm not worthy. I'm a sinner.
Could it be because they're the only ones that believed your blasphemous lies?
Matthew, when you're healthy, do you go to the doctor?
No.
Healthy people don't need a doctor. Sick people do. I have not come to call on those that think they're healthy, but those that know they are sinners. Follow me and be my disciple.
As Moses said, so do not corrupt yourselves by making an idol in any form.
whether of a man or a woman, an animal on the ground or a bird in the sky, a small animal that scurries along the ground or a fish in the deepest sea. And when you look up into the sky and see the sun and the moon and the stars, don't be seduced into worshiping them. The Lord your God gave them to all the people of all the earth. Remember that the Lord rescued you from the iron smelting furnace of Egypt in order to make you his very own and his special possession, which is what you are today.
Look, it's Jesus!
No, wait! No! I am not done teaching from the law!
Be careful.
Listen, if you have a lamp, do you put it under a bed or a bowl? No, you put it on its stand so it can give light. Everything that is secretive will be brought to the open. Everything that is in darkness will be brought to the light. All who have ears, listen and understand.
Look, that man needs help.
Sir, let me help you.
Jesus! I'm crippled!
Here, sit up.
Can you help me?
My child, your sins are forgiven.
Did you hear that blasphemy? Who are you that you think you have the authority to forgive sin?
Only God can forgive sin, and you are not God.
You have no right to tell this man his sins are forgiven.
Why are you saying these things? What's easier for me to say, your sins are forgiven, or get up and walk? But I will show you that the Son of Man has the power to forgive the sins of the earth. Stand up.
Thank you, Jesus.
Go on,
thank
peace.
You. I can walk.
Who does he think has given him the authority to do such things?
God has.
Blasphemy! If your friend continues to blaspheme God in this way, it's not going to end well for him.
This is only the beginning.
Teacher, please, listen, it's my daughter, and she's getting worse, and I don't know what's going to happen.
Calm down, we can barely understand you.
Listen, she's sick, and she's getting worse, and if you don't come, I'm afraid she's going to die. Please, come, you've got to help me.
Take me to her.
It's this way.
I'm sorry your daughter is dead. No use for you. Yes, I would hit the teacher right now.
Don't lose hope. Jesus has performed many miracles.
Here, let us see her. Surely there's something Jesus can do.
Just have faith. She'll be healed.
But they've already said she's dead. There's no point for you to see her.
Where is she?
She's right over here.
Sir.
Please, do something.
Your child is not dead. She's just asleep. My child. Wake up.
I can't believe it! Oh my God! It's a miracle! Your body was lifeless, and now you're... How did this happen? I don't understand. We have to celebrate. We have to tell everybody we can. Listen! Hey, we gotta celebrate!
There's many things that I need to teach you. All in the right time. For now, let's go find a place to rest. Who touched me?
Master, the whole crowd is pressing against you.
Look at all these people.
Lord, how could just one have touched you when such a crowd is pressing against you?
No, somebody deliberately touched me. I felt power go out from me.
What do you mean?
Lord, I'm sorry. I've been sick for so very long. For 12 years, I've been an outcast, and no one wanted to be around me. I've spent everything, and now I have nothing. I've given up everything to try and make this stop, and I can't. But then I heard of you, Lord, and the miracles you performed, and I thought maybe if I could just be close to you, maybe you would heal me. I thought maybe if I could just touch the hem of your robe, that I would be made whole. And I have. I've been made whole.
My daughter, your faith has made you well.
Well, frightened and embarrassed, I
Who do people say that I am?
The people say many things about who you are.
Some say that you are John the Baptist.
Some say Elijah.
Others say you are one of the ancient prophets, raised from the dead.
But who do you say I am?
What do you mean?
You're the Messiah, sent from God.
Listen, you can't tell anyone who I am. Not yet.
Why, Lord?
Master, wouldn't it be better for people to know who you truly are?
There's a lot of things that have to come to pass first. Like, the Son of Man is going to suffer many things.
Lord, we don't understand.
What things?
I'm going to be rejected by the elders, by the chief priests, and the teachers of law. I'm going to be beaten, and I'm going to be killed. But on the third day, I will rise again.
What you're saying, surely that's not true.
All these things have to happen in time. And if any of you wants to come after me, you must deny yourself, take up your cross, and follow me every day. If you try to gain your life, you'll lose it. But if you lose it for my sake, you'll find it. For I tell you the truth, some sitting here right now will surely not die before they see the kingdom of God.
His following grows bigger every day. Some are even calling him a king.
A king? A king of beggars, liars, and thieves, maybe. But he's no real king. We've seen many like him before. They come making these claims, and then the people rejoice. But he'll soon fade away and be forgotten just like the rest.
How can you be so blind? The crowds are following, they listen to his words. They're starting to believe his lies. They love him. They think he's a king. They threaten a peace, and if it continues, it's going to fall on us.
Maybe you're right. Maybe it's time we did something.
We can't do it in public. He's always ready with some well-spoken response. People hang on his every word. They'll never listen to us.
What about his followers?
His followers? What do you mean?
Surely one of them would be willing to help us if the price were right.
Go play somewhere else. We're trying to rest.
No, no. Anyone who welcomes a child like this welcomes me. And anyone who welcomes me welcomes my Father who sent me.
Why do you spend so much time out here talking to us?
Yeah, shouldn't you be with all the other teachers?
Let me tell you a story. If you had 100 sheep and you lost one, what would you do? I'll tell you what the shepherd does. The shepherd leaves the 99, he goes out, and he finds his one lost sheep. And when he finds it, you know what he does? He puts it on his shoulders, and he goes home, and he begins dancing and praising God, and he says, "Praise God, I have found my lost sheep." So I tell you the truth, there is more rejoicing in heaven over one lost person who is found than over 99 people that think they don't need to be found.
Who are you?
My name is Judas. I've come here to talk to you about Jesus.
You're one of his followers, aren't you?
Yes. I understand you want to arrest Jesus for the things he's said and done.
So, you'd be willing to help us with that?
Well, what would you be willing to give me for my help?
It can't happen during Passover. Now, the people will revolt. Now, it's got to be done away from the crowds.
Very well. I'll wait until the time is right, when he's alone with his disciples. I'll greet him with a kiss on the cheek so that your soldiers know to who to arrest.
Thank you for your help.
Lord, are you going to wash my feet?
You don't understand what I'm doing now.
One day you will.
You will not wash my feet.
Peter, unless I wash you, you'll have no place with me.
Then wash my hands or my head. Just not my feet, Lord.
Anyone who's bathed all over just needs to wash their feet. Do you understand what I was doing? You call me teacher and Lord, and that's right. That's what I am. But since I, your teacher and Lord, have washed your feet, you should wash the feet of others. I've given you an example to follow. I've been looking forward to this Passover meal for a very long time, before my suffering begins. We will not eat this again till the kingdom of God is here.
What do you mean?
What suffering?
Listen, this is my body, which is broken for you. Whenever you eat it, do it in remembrance of me. Take and eat. And this cup is the new covenant in my blood, poured out for you. Whenever you drink it, do it in remembrance of me. A little while, you won't see me anymore. After that, you will see me again.
Lord, we don't understand.
Why are you saying we won't see you anymore?
Lord, you keep saying that you're going to leave and that you must suffer, but why?
I told you, you won't see me, but you will see me again. I tell you the truth. You will weep and you will mourn over what is about to happen to me. And the world will rejoice. But your weeping will turn to joy. And nobody can take that joy from you. Here, come over here. Keep watch. I'm going to go over there and pray. My soul is crushed to the point of death.
We'll be here.
Father, if it is possible, take this cup from me, but not my will be done, but yours.
Father, let
Couldn't you keep watch for an hour? Wake up. You have to keep watch so that you will not fall into temptation. Stand up. Look. My time has come.
Greetings, Rabbi.
Betray me with a kiss. Do what you've come for.
Lord, should we fight?
Put your sword away. Those who live by the sword die by the sword. Am I some dangerous revolutionary that you come with swords to arrest me? Why didn't you arrest me when I was in the temple teaching every day? But this is happening to fulfill the prophets. Since I'm the one you want, let everybody else go.
My son, where is my son?
They took him last night.
We don't know where.
They took him at night?
They're scared they took him during the day they realized.
Be it known, the High Court of the Elders has tried Jesus of Nazareth. He's been found guilty of blasphemy and of threatening to tear down the temple. He is being taken to Pilate. His sentence is death.
No!
What are the charges against this man that you have brought to me? Why ask? We wouldn't have brought him if he weren't a criminal. Why bring him to me? Take him and try him by your own laws.
Only the Roman courts are permitted to issue an execution, so we brought him here to you. He's being held outside with the guards.
Very well. I will judge for myself. Centurion, bring me Jesus of Nazareth, please. Are you a king? I said, are you a king?
Is this your question? Or something you heard about me?
Am I a Jew? Your own people and your chief priests have brought you to me for trial. Why? What have you done?
My kingdom is not of this earth. If it was, my people would fight for me. The kingdom is not of this world.
So, you are a king.
You say I'm a king. Actually, I've come to testify to the truth.
What is truth? Guard, go bring the Barabbas.
Let go of me. I'm telling you, I am innocent.
Hush. I have found no guilt in this man. But, as a sign of goodwill, I will release one prisoner to you because of your Passover. Who will it be? Barabbas? Or the King of the Jews?
He's no king of ours!
You must decide! You must decide!
Barabbas!
You choose this murderer? Over this preacher?
Barabbas!
Barabbas! He's no king of ours! Centurion, take Jesus out of my sight.
Crucify him!
Guards! Guards! Set Barabbas free!
Yeah!
Oh, he's free!
I find no guilt in Jesus of Nazareth, and I'm going to release him to you.
Crucify him!
Crucify him!
Crucify him!
Very well. Take him yourselves and crucify him. But a sign will be nailed to his cross that says, Jesus of Nazareth, King of the Jews.
No, it must read, he said he was the king of the Jews.
No, it will be written as I have said.
Crucify him!
Crucify
him! He's no king.
This way. Mock him. Haven't they done enough?
Should we bow to the king?
Some king.
Daughters of Jerusalem, weep not for me. Weep for yourselves and your children. Father, forgive them. They don't know what they're doing. Father,
into your arms, I commit my spirit. It is finished.
Oh, Said would happen.
Dear woman, who is it you're looking for?
Sir, if you have taken away my Lord, tell me where he is so I can go get him.
Mary. Mary.
Teacher!
Tell our brothers that I'm back, just like I said I would be. Now, we've got work to do.